stay safe, spend your quality time with your family member. You can give your quality time in your study also. Play some indoor games, eat healthy foods. I hope whatever homework I am giving you in maths and science, you are doing it on time in your homework, because whenever a school is going to open, I am going to check all the homework which I am giving to you. So today I am going to teach you science, chapter 5, page number 55, okay, types of soil. So based on the proportion of the different types of soil, particles present, soils are of three main types, okay, sandy soil, clay soil and loamy soil. Now proportion means to say the share of something in relation to the whole, right? If this is a soil particle, okay, and if this soil particle is divided into three parts, like one part, two part, this is first part, this is second part, this is three part. So in these three proportion, the first will be, okay, the first, not first, one proportion will be sandy soil, second one will be clay soil, and third will be loamy soil. On the basis of proportion, proportion means they share equal part of a whole. See, all will share equal part of a whole. Or equal not, then they should be not equal, but in proportion they share some part to the whole. Not equal, they share some part of the whole. So we'll see first about sandy soil, okay? This is on the proportion of the different types of soil. These types of soil, I'm going to explain on the proportion of, based on the proportion, okay, this proportion of different types of soil. Three types of soils are here. First is sandy soil. This soil has a greater proportion of sand particles in it and is rough and gritty in texture. It is non-sticky when wet. The soil particles have a lot of space between them, and hence the soil does not hold a lot of water. Therefore, sandy soil is not very suitable for growing plants. Okay, that's why it is not suitable for growing plants, because it has a lot of space. In sandy soil, the spaces between the particles, they are too much. That's why it is not very suitable for the growth of plants. Okay, has a greater proportion of sand particles and it's very rough. If you have touched sand particles, then when you have touched, then you will find it is very rough. Okay, so the soil has a greater proportion of sand particles, okay, and it is rough. When you will touch sand particles, it is very rough and it is gritty in texture. Means when you will touch, you will find lot of rough surface. Okay, so you will find like if you have touched salt, in salt also small particles are there. So as same as it is in sand also, when you will touch it, it is very rough and it is very gritty, okay? It is like a small crystal. Yes, it is non-sticky when wet. When you will apply water to the sand, it is non-sticky. It is non-sticky when wet, okay? Non-sticky means it will not look like a gum. But when you will apply water to the clay particle, it will totally become sticky like a gum, okay? Like a fabric. and that's why the soil particles have a lot of space between them, and soil does not hold a lot of water due to the space, due to the lot of spaces, okay, between particles, it cannot hold up a lot of water. Okay, in sand particle they are very spaces between their particles, so it cannot hold lot of water, and it is not very suitable for growing plants. Okay, if you are growing plants in sandy soil, then your plants will not grow. It will grow, but it is not suitable. It is not very suitable for growing plants. Okay, so but if you are thinking that you want to grow some plants in sandy soil, so please avoid it. You will not get proper plants in this soil. Now we'll go to clay soil. Number two. Now come to clay soil. Soil has a greater proportion of clay particles. This name is clay soil. That's why this soil has a greater particles of this soil has a greater particles of clay particles. And what is clay? It is very sticky. When you will apply water to it, it will become like a sticky, okay, like a gum. It